Hi, I'm Graham Mossman from Exasol, and today I'm going to show you how to load data into your EXASolution Community Edition database. Here is my network at home. I have a Linux machine, which I use for hosting databases, and I have a Windows laptop that I use for accessing databases. I have EXA+ installed on both machines, and the EXASolo database is running as a virtual machine on the Linux server. So, how do I load data? Well, firstly, it's the wrong approach to put data files into the virtual machine image. EXASol don't provide any operating system login details for the virtual machine. This isn't because EXASol don't trust their users, rather it's because there's a better way of loading data. So long as you load data files from the same physical machine as your database, you will get excellent load speeds. So in my case, I should put my load files onto the physical Linux machine and not into the virtual machine. Could I load the files from my Windows machine? Well, yes I could, but my home network is not enormously fast, and the load this way would be much slower. Here is a demonstration using the TPCH dataset, which is available from tpc.org. As I discussed before, I need to have the data files on my Linux machine in order to get the best load speed. Then I just need to use EXA+ to import the data into the tables, changing any of the parameters that I need to. If I want to use any advanced options for the load, I can use this rather neat trick to pull the import statement into a query window and add any extra options. Full details of the options available are in the user guide. So in conclusion, the best way to load data is from the physical machine hosting the database. You can't put load files directly into the operating system of the virtual machine, and you should avoid loading big files from across a slow network. I hope this has been useful. Please refer to the user guide and exasol.com for further details, and thanks for listening.